I'm here in the middle of sunflowers. Now, you yourselves may not grow this many, but I really wanted to do a couple tests to see the best way to grow the best sunflowers for a variety of uses. One of the things that I did learn is you need to time your sunflowers and plant them maybe every 2 or 3 weeks, starting sometime in early summer. And that'll give you sunflowers that are coming into bloom, in bloom, finished blooming. It also gives you an opportunity to harvest sunflowers throughout the whole season. I learned a couple things. When you plant your sunflower seed, don't mix the varieties. Here I sort of mixed some varieties, so some are tall, some are short. And what I found is that I may have planted them a little too close and we had a windstorm and they blew over. So if you're going to have tall ones in maybe one area and short ones in another area, keep them separate. I grew over 20 varieties of sunflowers this year. Some are real short, maybe 24 inches, and some can get up, 10, 12, or even taller in height. The ideal time to irrigate them is about 3 or 4 weeks right before they come into flower. Once they come into flower, I have found you want to cut off on the watering, because if you water them too much at that time, again, if you have a windstorm, I find that sometimes they're not as well rooted as I'd like, and they will fall over again in high winds at very times during the, depending on a season, it could be in September and October, even in August, we'll get those times with a lot of wind. Now, the other thing I want to show you is how you can harvest them and how you can store them, and also how you can use them as a cut flower. So when you're cutting them as cut flowers, you want to get them where they're nice and fresh, not a lot of pollen, so when you bring them indoors, they don't drop pollen all over the house. And after you've cut them nice and fresh, you then, instead of stripping the leaves by hand, I have found just coming in with a shears or a sharp knife, just remove some of these lower leaves, depending on the arrangement that you have. And then instead of putting them in cool water, I found that putting them in warm water, they lasted, 3, 4, 5, maybe even 6 days indoors. The birds aren't waiting for me to harvest and feed them these sunflower heads, but what we had to do here is just to keep the birds out is to go ahead and protect and cover them. And now again, you can individually do it, or you can cover the whole area with a cloth that allows a lot of light and a lot of dryness to occur. Now, when you start the harvest, and there's a couple ways you can do this. One is you want to look at the back of the sunflower. When the back of the sunflower starts to turn yellow, and really a bright yellow, you can cut them and you can lay them in a dry place, maybe, doesn't get a lot of humidity, and lay them, right on their backs like this on shelves. But one of the reasons that I want to harvest them and dry them in the field is that as they begin to turn yellow, they'll eventually turn brown, and you will have sunflowers that are perfectly dried on a stem that you can stick in your trees and shrubs to feed the birds. Now, every couple days, we make our birds work for their seed. And as you can see here, we just stick, you don't need the giant sunflowers, even the little ones that they love. And we just come out in the garden, and you just take your sunflowers, and you just stick them on your feeder like this. Now, you can stick these in your shrubs, you can lay these on a flat feeder, you can even take an old stump, and maybe, leave it about the height that I am, cover it with chicken wire, and stick your sunflowers in them. Just change them occasionally. And what you're going to find is after a couple days, you're going to have something that started out like this, and it's going to look just like this. And I never realized how much the finches and some of the other birds love fresh sunflower. Not a week old, not a month old, not 3 months old. We pick it, and we put it on the feeder, and they come all day long. And one thing you might forget, and you may never even think about it, and that is to stake your sunflowers. Now, I made the mistake. I grew these beautiful sunflowers, woke up one morning, and the wind had blown many of them over. And that means just take a metal stake, drive it into the ground. It's got to be pretty substantial, or a heavy, wooden stake, and use high tensile wire or wire that's not going to break, or string that's not going to break. And you might wonder, well, why do I have to do that? Well, the reason is that if you're lucky enough, your sunflowers might get this big. Now, you know, one thing I really haven't talked about, and that is sunflowers provide a great source of pollen for your bumblebees and honeybees. And if I had to pick one plant that I saw more honeybees on and more bumblebees on, it was on my fields of sunflowers. So if anything, grow your sunflowers for the honeybees. I'm Mark Viette. Join me next time in the garden.
For more garden tips, go to the In the Garden website at www.inthegardenradio.com.